So the first biomolecule we want to look at in detail is the carbohydrates. And carbohydrates includes sugars, starches, cellulose, and chitin, among a few other things. As we go through each one of these biomolecules, we're going to talk about both the structure and the function, and they're sort of listed separately here, but remember that these two things are closely connected. The structure leads to the function. So the monomer of a carbohydrate is a simple sugar ring, such as glucose, galactose, or fructose. And when you build a carbohydrate, you're going to take a series of these rings and put them together. If you just have one ring of sugar, we call it a monosaccharide. Saccharide is Latin for sugar. A disaccharide means two, so this is two units of sugar bonded together, and a polysaccharide is many sugars bonded together. Poly means many. Polysaccharides are better known as complex carbohydrates. So when you eat pasta, for example, that's full of starch. Starch is a polysaccharide. It's many glucose rings put together, as opposed to something simple like sucrose, which is just two units of sugar bonded together. Cellulose is going to be a complex carbohydrate that's important in plants. Glycogen, I mentioned earlier, is a different form of energy that we store in our liver and our muscle cells. So here we can see sucrose. Sucrose is made of a glucose monomer and a fructose monomer held together, and so it's a disaccharide. And this is obviously a kind of sugar that we have in our diets regularly. So the function of carbohydrates in animals, the function of carbohydrates is to produce short-term energy, and specifically we're going to use it to make ATP. We will learn about that process later in the semester. For plants, carbohydrates are going to be used for short-term energy as well to make ATP, but they also use carbs for a few additional things. They use it to store long-term energy. So we're going to use fats or lipids to store energy. Plants actually use starches, and that should make sense. We like to eat starches. We get lots of energy. When you're eating a potato, the potato was not produced for us, but that was the plant trying to store its energy for the future. They also use carbohydrates to build physical structures like cell walls out of a carbohydrate called cellulose. The second kind of macromolecule we're going to mention are proteins. And protein monomer is an amino acid. There are 20 different kinds of amino acids, and each has different chemical characteristics. Nine are essential. And when you say something is an essential nutrient, an essential amino acid, that means that you have to get it from your food. Our body is not able to build it. The other 11 our bodies are able to build from other building blocks. The protein, then, is a chain of amino acids that are folded into a complex three-dimensional shape. The next video you'll watch will give you an idea of the different chemical characteristics of amino acids and how they could fold on each other into a complex three-dimensional shape. Please note that I want you to use this as a visual so that you can start to see how proteins might come together. But the discussion of all the different kinds of amino acids and the different levels of primary, secondary, quaternary structure is not something we're going to learn in this class.